Hi everybody, my name is Alyssa. I would like to welcome you to the first installment of Confessions of a Late Makeup Bloomer, because I am 37 years old and it took me until just now to truly love makeup and to really start experimenting with it. And I watch all these videos, let me tell you, these videos that are on YouTube are amazing tutorials, but I gotta tell you, when you're an amateur like myself, it's very intimidating because I know I'm not going to look like that right off. It's going to take a lot of practice. So, for anybody who is a late bloomer like me, we are going to learn together. How's that sound? All right. So, give me just a second. We're going to set up and then we will start it again. Am I back? I'm back. Oh, gosh. So, these videos are so hard for me. All right. So, I know a lot of this stuff has to do with application and the tools that you use. Well, I'm very limited on tools right now. I am working on building up my brush sets. I only have, you know, a little bit here and there, but we are going to work with what we have. So, because I am an amateur, I am really just going to do one thing that I'm very good at, and that is like a very natural everyday look for those everyday people who just don't have time or maybe the energy to do like an hour of makeup at a time. I mean, I know these videos show it done in like 15-20 minutes, but there is pausing in between while they do things. So without further ado, what I did is I primed my face with the Touch Glorious Face Primer by Unique. Now, because I do things backwards, I am going to put on my concealer. It's also by Unique. It's the Touch Skin Perfecting Concealer in the shade Taffeta. Now, if my hair would stay out of my eye, I'll smooth it back with some of that leftover primer I have on my fingers. I love this primer. Although I have to admit, I haven't really tried a lot of different primers, so I did just order one. Yesterday, I can't remember who it's by, but let me tell you, that's not a good mirror look. When I get it, I will try it on with you guys and see if it makes any difference, because see, I have like these huge pores. I wish I could show that. You might be able to see them if you like really look. There's huge, deep, giant crevices in my skin that absolutely drives me nuts. I use a lot of concealer. I do. I mean, if you look at it, it's just like a little dot there, but like I have to put it all over under my eyes. And who knows, maybe there's like a better trick there. I'm not sure. I'm still working at it. I also have to put it over my eyes because my circles are absolutely ridiculous. This could be, you know, like circles I earn from having kids, because let's face it, those of us who have kids, we have circles too. Now, I only give it the slightest bit of blending because I'm just going to do a BB cream. I love tinted moisturizers when it comes to like the winter time, because as much as I have oily skin, the winter sucks the moisture right out and I don't even get like my oily skin. It gets really dry. My nose gets scaly. I never really knew how to fix it and I never really cared to learn how to fix it before because I have not been a makeup guru, let me tell you. It had to be forced on me when I was a little kid. Not a little kid. Like 16. I think, what was it I was told? I look like a boy with boobs. So then I had to start wearing makeup. Well, I never really cared to look up, you know, the proper techniques and how to put it on. So I'm sure I looked a hot mess for many, many years. Now, I am using Unique's BB Flawless Skin Perfecting Complexion Enhancer. It's a tinted moisturizer. I had a tiny bit of concealer left and I just mixed it in with my BB cream. I just do it on the back of my hand. Again, late bloomer, I could be doing everything absolutely wrong. This is a foundation brush. I'm sure it's better for like, I don't know, powder foundations or maybe the cream ones. I like to use it for my BB cream. I call it like a little, it's my little personal blend. And then I take this liquid foundation brush that's also by Unique, because like I said, I am building up my brush collection. And I use it to just kind of buff it all into my skin. Now, I apologize for the lighting in here. When I do videos on my phone, the lighting looks like 1,000 times better. However, I'm using my computer, and I haven't figured out like the best placement for my light ring. If I look to the side, it's just because I'm trying to see what I'm doing in the mirror. The lighting just looks so much different in my computer. I have a nice healthy glow in my mirror, but in this computer, I look really, really pasty. Pasty, pasty, pasty. Like I said, honestly, I have... Well, I can't say I have no clue on, you know, how to put on makeup, because I have been watching a lot of videos. I started in with the company Unique. I became a presenter, and I watch the videos, and I see some of my Y sisters, and they do such amazing makeup tutorials, but I'm not a pro yet. So what I thought I would do is I would start a YouTube channel, Confessions of the Late Bloomer, who is almost 40 and just now starting to put on makeup. And I figured, why not learn on YouTube? Put up a more realistic person who honestly has no clue what the hell she's doing and see where it gets us. Right? Right. Now, I do know about setting makeup. I have learned that much. So I put my BB cream on. I blended it down my neck because, you know, nobody likes that harsh line into my hairline, all that good stuff. Now I'm taking just a pressed powder, and I'm just going to kind of push it into my skin a little bit. I'm not swiping. I don't want to leave marks. I want to just pat it into my skin. It's supposed to set my makeup. I shouldn't sound so skeptical, because I know it does. It actually works better than just letting it sit all on its own. Something else I did not know. Now, for anybody who watches this, you know of some awesome products or some amazing brushes, because I can't just order them online. I'm kind of weird. I want to touch them. I want to know if they're soft. I don't want anything funky feeling on my face. I'm kind of picky about that. I don't know. Maybe it's like an OCD thing. Not sure. But products or brushes. Brushes are a big one for me. I need some good name, like the names of some good brushes. I could go to Ulta, but honestly, I don't know one from the other. I'm absolutely amazed when I watch these videos and I see they're just pulling out brush after brush after brush after brush. And I'm like, my sorry little collection, I can't even say it pales in comparison. It's like non-existent in comparison. So, here we go. I got rid of my circles. I have a much more even skin tone. I had a really nasty blemish right here, which you can't see now, thank God, because it's right under my eye. That's where people look. Now, I am dropping stuff left and right. That is awesome. Go me. So, like I said, I like the really natural looks. If it's an everyday look, that's what I like to do, because I'm sorry, every day, I'm not going to do a cut crease to go to work. I drive a school bus, okay? I'm a mom of two. I drive a school bus. I have an emo kid. I have a kid who's no longer wanting to hang out with me. He's slowly pulling away, so I don't even have my mama's boy kid. It's very depressing. So I am immersing myself in learning how to be a girl again. I've always, you know, taken really great care of my hair. I have awesome hair. I will admit that. I have awesome hair. And I always smell good, because Bath and Body Works, hello. They need a 12-step program for that place. Now it's makeup time. This is my favorite palette. It's the Moodstruck Addiction Palette 1 from Unique. But I love all the bronzies and the browns and the shimmery colors. I think they're amazing. Now, because we are the beginner, because I have absolutely no clue, well, very little clue, on exactly how things go. I kind of pick things as I like them. Okay. I don't say, okay, this is number one, this is number two, this is number three. I'm like, okay, what do I feel like today and how do I want to put it on? Sometimes it turns out really, really great. Other times I need to wipe it off and then I give up. So that being said, what do I want to do? I think I want to take I love Swanky. I can't help it. Swanky is this, like, really, really awesome color right here. It's shimmery. I know a lot of people say save the shimmer for, you know, like a little spot. I love shimmery colors. I'm like, I want to sparkle. You know, take me to Forks, make me sparkle. Maybe not to that extent, but pretty stinking close. Now, I'm learning the whole tap off the excess because I think that's where I always ran into problems the very, like, few times that I tried to put on makeup is I would put a ton of product on my brush and then it would turn into, like, this crazy hot mess that it's, I'm fairly certain is kind of part of why I got picked on a bunch in school. Possibly. It could be the reason. Now, I do put it all over my lid, but I'm actually going to cover some of it up. I really wish this lighting is pissing me off. Excuse my French, but it is making me angry. But we'll deal with it for today. I will find a better way to do it later. Right? Right. I wonder if I close my natural lady windows. You know, I think we might just pause this video for a hot second and see what happens when I do that. So again, as you can see, I probably have like the most horrendous makeup skills ever, but I cannot be the only one out there who does not know what she's doing. Now, give me 2 seconds. We're going to try and fix this lighting. It's making me angry. Did I pause it? No, I didn't pause it. Well, I can honestly say I don't think it made that much of a difference. But do you like my curtain in the back? I think it's beautiful. And you know, when I'm on my phone, it doesn't show like the other parts of my office area. If you want to call it an office. All right, grab my brush. Now, I guess I should have said what brush I was using. This is Unique's angled shadow sponge brush. I don't really use the spongy side at all, but I love the angled brush. Now, this is the one thing I do know about angled brushes, okay? I have one by ELF that, you know, I got at Walmart for like, I don't know, $2. And I have this one by Unique. They are pretty much identical. I mean, there's a slight difference, but not much. One thing I have noticed is the application from this is not nearly as good as the one from this. Now, here's the question to all my YouTube watchers, if anybody does watch this. If you have an angled shadow brush, what one do you like? What one's your favorite one? Because I got to tell you, I love this one by Unique, but I'm really curious to see if there's some other ones out there that you find to be absolutely amazing. I want to try them. Like I said, I'm this amateur who knows absolutely nothing of what she's doing, but I kind of want to know. I need to know. I feel kind of left out in the whole girly pool thing. Now, let's see. Something I have learned is if you're going to smoke anything, go up, not out. Don't draw it down. You want your eye to go up. And like I've always said, a little bit. Don't go heavy-handed like I usually do. Just a little bit. God. I'm really hoping doing all these videos, like, teaches me a little something, you know? Helps me figure all this chiz out. I want to know how everybody else learned. Is it seriously just by playing with it over and over and over? Because I have, like, no imagination when it comes to this stuff. I sit there and I'm like, what the heck did I just grab? I sit here and I play with it, and you know what? I gotta tell you, it looks absolutely the same every single time I do it, no matter how I do it. Oh, that has some product on it from last night when I was trying to figure out how to do a cut crease, because I just got some it's got a little like pinkish purple hue going on, but I'm kind of digging it in the mirror. It looks funky in the video, though, doesn't it? Looks funky. Like, I almost want to bring it up a little bit. Oh, you guys are going to have a field day with me on this, on these reviews, aren't you? But that is how we learn. Don't be too harsh, though, seriously. Because I admitted there is nothing in my title that says I am a pro and I know exactly what I'm doing. I am looking to learn. I am looking for tips. And I am looking for people who are just like me who absolutely have no clue on how to put on makeup and would like to learn, but feel a little weird asking because you know what? Look at how old I am. Seriously, look how old I am. And I have no idea how to put on makeup. Like, I watch videos and I figure some stuff out. Like, you know, if you want to blend, grab the end of the brush because you don't want to get too heavy-handed with it. If you're going to place your makeup, grab a little bit more on here so you can pat it in. You know. Unless you're like an 80s queen, try to stay away from the crazy blue eyeshadows. You know, that type of stuff. I have that part figured out. But no, not a pro. Not a pro at all. Now, I cheat. I mean, don't get me wrong. I know how to draw on my eyebrows, and I've done it. Probably not the best way. I really need to have them shaped because they're kind of on the funky side, I guess. But on the weekends or, you know, if I'm in a really big hurry, I cheat and I use my eyeshadow to just kind of place some eyebrows on there just to make them a little bit more uniform. And that's kind of what I'm going to do today because it's Sunday. I'm sorry, I'm feeling lazy. I don't know if anybody else has done this, but I find it's a great trick if you're in a hurry and you don't have a whole lot of time, but you don't want to leave the house with your eyebrows looking like they got sad and ran away from home. You know what I'm saying. And let me tell you, I did not learn about the whole eyebrows are important thing until I started watching videos. Does that make me a sad human being? I think it does. Oh, that probably had something on it from last night too. Fudge a duck. See, I'm trying to watch my language. But I need help, people. I do. I need help. I need to know what I'm doing, you know? I don't want to not know what I'm doing. I want to look decent when I do this stuff. Hold that thought. Ooh, score. So, I exfoliated my lips today. Did you know you're supposed to exfoliate your lips? Did you? Did anybody? Because seriously, I had no clue. But then I finally found, like I said, I just found the whole makeup thing. And your color stays better if you don't have all that nasty dead skin on your lips. Who would have thought, right? I'm such a dork. So, I love how I'm wearing an Incredible Hulk shirt, but I'm putting on makeup. And the only people that are going to see me are my kids. And they think, why do I always try and talk when I'm putting on this stuff? They think I'm awesome all by myself, so I don't really have to have makeup for my kids. But I choose to. For once, I don't have the shakes. I've been dieting. And you know when you get hungry, you shake. Like my lip did. Sometimes my lip shakes like I'm just like jonesing for something. Probably like some fried chicken or, you know, a cheeseburger. But, dang it, I'm kind of done being fluffy, you know? Now, this is one of my favorite lipsticks, honestly. It's a liquid lip by Unique. It's the Lip Splash. It dries to a matte finish, but it stays for a really, really long time. And I've tried, like, the CoverGirl ones, the, you know, like, 18-hour lip stain or lipstick where it's one tube and at one end is your color and the other end is, like, this clear stuff that you put over it. And it could be that my lips were just janky, all right? I will admit this. It could be my lips. However, I had this problem where within like 30 minutes, it would feel like all the moisture was sucked out of my mouth. I didn't like that feeling. It was not a pleasant feeling. I'm trying to find the right brush that I want. So I quit using it, and I felt like I was wasting all this money on makeup. Well, then I learned, you know, if you get some of the pricier makeup that doesn't have like all the weird, funky chemicals in it, that guess what? Your lips won't feel like they've been trashed. You know? Did you know that? I did not know that. Because, like I said, late stinking bloomer. Do you know how embarrassing it is to be almost 40 years old and not know how to apply makeup? Which, let me tell you, my mirror view, seriously, I look so much prettier in that than I do on this camera. I'm going to have to, like, invest in a camera if we're going to keep doing this. Now, I do have a liner brush. I'm trying to decide if I'm going to do it like this. Because I am just really trying to keep it natural. Very, very natural. I sprayed it a little bit with some rose water, which can be used as a setting spray. It's also great for so many other things that I've heard, but I haven't tried it on yet. And if nothing else, it smells like roses. If they could make one with the scent of, like, lilacs, that would be awesome. I love lilacs. Do you not love lilacs? I love lilacs. I'm throwing stuff at myself. All right, so I'm missing a bunch of stuff here. I am going to throw some color onto my face. I have this great bronzer. It's got a shimmery side. It's got a matte side. You mix them together. It becomes awesome. That's fantabulous. I've been trying to learn how to contour because I have, like, this giant forehead. And I heard it's great for giant foreheads when you don't want your forehead to be so stinking giant. Now, I don't go crazy with it. I just put a little bit on because I do have really great cheekbones when you can find them. I don't contour my nose. I will admit this. And I don't go crazy with it. I just throw some color on there. And then kind of floof it out. Again, people, brushes. Brushes, brushes, brushes. If nothing else, comment about brushes or a technique or a product that you love. But this is how me, the single mom of two boys, who no longer seems to think that she's, like, the coolest thing in the world, which is, like, the saddest thing in my world. This is how I've been doing it for forever. And it's actually improved greatly because, like I said, I don't look like a French whore. I no longer look like I'm trying to sell myself on the side of the road. I only have a blusher, but this is my favorite blusher. It's a very natural looking blusher. And I'm weird. I kind of pat it on and then give it a little sweep just for a natural look. Slight smile just so I can find the stinking balls of my cheeks. Then, because sometimes I feel it looks a little too bold, I kind of blend it up with that bronzer I had just to kind of buff it out a little bit. I really don't want to look too made up. Is there such a thing as too made up? I don't know. I think there is. I see some people, it looks like they spray painted their faces on, and it kind of scares me because I wonder what they look like without all that makeup. I try to look like a healthier version of myself because with those giant circles that I have, which you no longer see, thank you, concealer and BB cream. Thanks to that, I don't look like I'm exhausted all the time. And I'm pretty picky about, like, foundations. Usually I'm just like a powder foundation person because I don't like a heavy feeling foundation. I don't want it to feel like I have stuff caked onto my face. But I will say this. I love the unique liquid touch foundation. It dries to a powder finish and it does not feel like I have anything on my skin. And it just looks really, really natural. It kind of blends right in. It's pigmented. Makes me happy. Although I have been seeing some other foundations on YouTube videos that I'm kind of curious to try just because I want to see what the difference is, just to see what the difference is, you know, how does it look on the face? So let's see, what is it I've seen everybody's big into this stuff called Urban Decay or what is it, Morphe. I have no idea what that stuff is. I'm clueless. Educate me, please, while I educate people like me. If I'm looking to the side, it's because that's where my mirror is. I am not skilled enough to put mascara on in the camera. Well, kind of am, but not really. I want to see what I'm doing. Oh gosh. I have no idea why I decided to start doing these videos, but I've always. I want to be liked for who I am, but it's hard to be liked for who you are when you don't even really take the time to put yourself together. And let's face it, we gravitate more towards people who look like they've taken some time to pull themselves together. I'm not saying you have to dress to the nines every single day and look like you were just like stepping out of a salon, but let me tell you, people who do at least a little something tend to get more recognition, more respect, and they respect themselves a lot more. I really have noticed this. So this is not like a bullshit thing. Do some people watching. Watch somebody who's not put together, looking like I did before I started putting on makeup, and then take a peek at somebody who is finally put together, looking like they, took the time and they actually care about their appearance, and watch how they're treated. I guarantee you will see at least a subtle difference, if not a huge difference. I know I've noticed it at work. I'm a bus driver, so I get up at 3:30 in the morning, and let me tell you, 9 times out of 10, the last thing I really want to do is sit in front of a mirror and put on makeup. But the way that even my coworkers treat me is completely different than when I do nothing at all. So, I go in and I'm looking all fine as hell, or at least for me, fine as hell. 'Cause ain't no beauty queen here. But when I'm looking good, they treat me differently, And it's weird and it's kind of crap because, I'm the same person without makeup as I am with makeup. But I'm still treated differently. I guess I should have told you, in case you were wondering, I am also, like, seriously, the majority of my makeup is unique. I am looking to branch out a little bit because I want to try other products because as much as I love these, and I seriously freaking love this stuff, I'm kind of curious to see how other stuff works too. You can't make good comparisons unless you actually shop around and try, see what there is. But this is their 3D fiber mascara, which I absolutely love. And if I was going out, I would jack these lashes up like nobody's business because they end up seriously looking like fake eyelashes, which I have no idea how to apply. I tried once. I think I almost jabbed my eyeball out. But think about it. Do some people watch and see what's different. But also, seriously, I was dead serious when I said I wanted you guys to comment on this and let me know about products, techniques, stuff that you've, played trial and error with and maybe you've learned over time because, hey, I am looking much better, right? See, I even carved that crap out. So this is the everyday kind of look for me. Although sometimes, honestly, I'll use my lip balm. It's just like again, a tinted moisturizer for my lips. It's a really natural look. But I decided to put on my liquid lip today just for the heck of it. Something different. Seriously, though, confessions of a late bloomer. I am that late bloomer. It's embarrassing to say. I see like 18-year-olds that are like doing this crazy wing liner, which I've done it once. I managed it once. I just need to find like a good quality liquid eyeliner that maybe is a little bit easier to apply and try it again because it didn't turn out bad the one time. But what I really want to learn, I will figure it out, is that cut crease. It's gonna happen. I will learn how to do a cut crease. It will look amazing, and you guys will watch me do it because, I think we're gonna do confession videos, not just about makeup, but beauty in general, I think, because I love my experts that I watch, but they could be freaking models. I mean, they're almost like almost unreal to me, and nothing against them except for this one. There's this one girl, Morgan. She is the bomb. I absolutely love her video. She cracks me up. She is so amazing with makeup, and she could probably be my daughter. Not in looks, but in age. But I'm going to edit this. Yeah. Boom. I'm hoping that everybody can appreciate a real person, a very amateur real person, struggling and sharing her journey with you to learning how to do different looks, you know. I want to be that hottie, dang it. My kids are almost grown. I want to get my hottie back. That's why I'm doing that whole diet thing, which diets suck. Diets make you hungry. They make you hungry. Speaking of which, it's time for my protein shake. So, everybody, comment below. Please subscribe. If nothing, I am Comic Relief. Maybe not as much today because I got a little sidetracked and I have like ADHD or something. I'm like, oh, shiny object. Subscribe. Give me the thumbs up. Share it with your friends because you know what? Again, I am not the only one who's a late bloomer. I can't be. I am not that cool. Sorry. Hate to break it to myself. Not that cool. And I really want tips from my pros. Anybody who's a late bloomer who has learned something that I have not learned yet. And you want to share your info. Greatly appreciated. Try to be nice. Be good to each other. Because you know what? Build up people. Don't break down. All right? Learn that. Build each other up. Don't break each other down. Let's be kind. This world sucks enough as it is. Let's not add to it. I love you all. Bye.